An old favorite, the Diesel Fitter Stout from Torque Brewing here in Winnipeg. Nice little roasty malty stout. I'm happy that all these new small breweries have popped up all over the place. Makes for some interesting choices. So this mailbag is a bonus mailbag because this is a long weekend here in Canada. It's Labor Day, spelled with a U, as is appropriate for a Commonwealth country. But the real reason we're here is to open the mail. I think I'm going to continue using the scalpel that I got in a previous mailbag, just because it's such a light touch to open it. So this says SMD resistor, and it is indeed a bunch of SMD resistors. Oh, I'm not seeing markings on the packages though. Could be wrong. Yeah, no markings on the outside of the packages. Damn it. Well, hopefully I can see through the windows. Oh yeah, I can see through the windows okay. What is that? 684, 680K, okay. All right, so I can work with that. That's reasonable. And I just picked these up just to stock up because you never know if you're fixing something. Like you may recall a few weeks ago when I was fixing that LED light, I had to use a salvaged LED from somewhere else. Things like that. 400 pieces, 0805 SMD resistor, 20 values, 10 ohm to 1 meg, assorted resistors assortment kit. From PowerHigh US. I don't think I paid shipping when I bought these, but $259 is in fact what I paid for them. Just something useful to have in shop stock, that's all. I didn't have a specific need for these, but you never know when you're going to need something. Next in, we have inductors kit. And that's quite possibly what it actually is, because I know I ordered an assortment of inductors, and yeah, that looks like exactly like what it is. Bunch of different inductors again, not well, shop stock basically for tinkering. I've been noticing there's a couple of circuits that I've been having my eyes on that need a bit of inductance, some voltage boosting stuff, some constant current stuff, and also just some general purpose oscillator kind of stuff. So we got here 150 microhenry, 100 microhenry, 1 microhenry, millihenry, sorry, 47 micro. Okay, so 2, 4, 6, 10 values. Let's go and check the listing for what they actually are. 50 pieces, 10 values, 8 times 10. 10 microhenry to 10 millihenry power inductors assortment kit, 100 220, 470 microhenry, 1 millihenry. Okay, from Robot Maker 2015. I think I've got a couple of things from them before. Inductors aren't super cheap for the quantity compared to some of the super cheap stuff, but I mean, still, that's a lot cheaper than buying them individually. These have 10 values, 5 pieces each for a total of 50 pieces. 10 micro, 22 micro, 33, 47, 100, 150, 220, 330, 1 milli, and 10 milli. Okay. Seems like a reasonable enough range to at least tinker with. That'll be handy.
Wonder if this is going to be more components. It says mini pliers. Tools. That could be interesting. In a miniature pouch. Ha ha ha! Little pocket size folding. How does that work? Like that and like that. Little keychain sized pliers. Spring loaded even. Oh, and some multi-tool-y kind of stuff in the handles too. Got a useless little file, nail file kind of thing. Yeah, that's not really all that worthy. What is that? Straight blade screwdriver and potentially pry bar, I suppose. What's in here? A fairly dull little tiny knife blade. And on that one, a kind of blunt Phillips-like screwdriver. Okay. And then down here, let's close this back up again. Down here we have little pair of pliers, and it looks like they've sort of got a wire cutter in there too. I got a piece of random wire here. Yeah, not so effective for 22 gauge. Try something a little bit heavier maybe. Do you have anything heavier lying around? How about this? This is 18 gauge stranded. It kind of distorts it. Yeah. If you're on a desert island and needed to cut some wire, I suppose that would work. Yes. So they're pretty average, as expected. I mean, you're not expecting quality when you're ordering this super cheap stuff from China, right? I just wanted to see what it was like. Because I've got, so my everyday carry is basically just a knockoff Swiss Army knife. I used to carry an actual Victorinox Swiss Army knife until I loaned it to somebody, and they lost it. So I've ever since I've had just a dollar store Swiss Army knife knockoff, and I'm just looking for something that might replace that cheap little thing. But I don't think this is it. Let's see how much or how little I spent for this. One pocket multifunction tool set mini foldaway keychain pliers knife screwdriver. Random keywords, but yeah, that's basically what it is. I got this thing at auction for $1.60. Seems most people are selling it for $3.10, something like that. Wow, I don't think it's worth that. If you can get one cheap at auction, well, I don't know if it's even worth that much. But it was an interesting experiment anyways. Here's one random listing. What do they say about it? Steel color, one piece, high quality stainless steel. I doubt it. Portable, powerful, mini plier function tools. And practical and convenient. Yes, it has a keychain loop. Easy to carry, sure. Multifunction, well, maybe. Well, you might be able to sharpen up the knife. It's a novelty. It was cheap. I just figured I'd try it and see what the hell I get for $1.50. You never know until you try.
Let's see if this gets any more interesting. That one doesn't say what it is. So at least we get some mystery here. Oh, looks like another cheap multi-tool in another cheap case. What is that? Multi-purpose pocket survival tool, 11 different functions. We have a can opener, number one, that part right there, sure. A knife edge, it's not entirely knifey. We have a screwdriver there on that corner. We have a ruler along there, which appears to be metric, which is nice. Can opener, or cap opener. Oh yeah, that's possibly the most useful tool on it. What else? Oh, this little multi wrench here. What claims to be a sort of a saw edge or a fish scaler or something? Could that cut wood? Oh, it'd have to be really bad wood. Four position wrench. That's this little thing in here. Do any bolts handy? Surprisingly, I don't. Now, what is a lanyard hole? That's a feature. Two position wrench. Which is the two position wrench? 10. Oh, okay. That's another little. Sure. Okay, whatever. What is number 9? Number 9 is direction ancillary indication. Okay, not a directional compass, but maybe a circle measuring kind of compassy thing. Sure. It says it's stainless. Now I realize that not all stainless is non-magnetic, but the some of the higher quality stuff usually is non-magnetic. That's very magnetic. I don't know, I'm not a metallurgist, that's just what I've heard. That's also another just looking for interesting and different potential everyday carry items.
again, I don't know if I'm going to use this one for anything, although it will function as a bottle opener, so that's a big plus.
Okay, this is another one of these things that I bought at auction for super cheap, and I can't find the listing. But anyway, New Black 11-in-1 Universal Outdoor Camping Survival Knife Pocket Card Tools. I got it for the princely sum of 81 cents at auction, and I've seen it locally since then in dollar stores, like Dollarama and stuff, for a buck and a quarter or whatever, or that kind of range. The eBay sellers seem to be selling it for in the two-ish dollar range, so there you go. I don't think there's much to be learned from looking deeper into the listing. The case is actually a feature. Woohoo! Ooh, it's your bonus number 12 feature. Cool.
So I gave this thing a little sharpening with a file, and it didn't really do very much. It's quite soft, actually. But we'll see if it's enough to open the next package, which says just a bunch of part numbers. Okay. Well, okay, it's sharp enough for that. I guess that's something. Oh, I've got some electronics. Cool, something interesting. Nice. Okay, what do we got here? This one has a knob on it. That could be useful, could be fun. What are you? You have some bent capacitors. You have a knob. Ooh, an on-off switch plus pot. Okay. There is a transistor on the back. We have a DC in and a motor. Oh, is that a PWM motor speed controller? Okay. There's a chip down under that capacitor. I wonder if I can bend it out of the way enough to see it without destroying it. Does that say 555? That might focus. That might actually be... This is pretty much the same circuit that I built out of a simple electronics kit. Probably pretty close, actually. Interesting. Okay, so, but this one looks like it's specifically calling for a motor. It says 3 to 15 volts there, DC in. Okay, there's a diode there, and a transistor there, and a bigger transistor there, marked Q2. And then three capacitors, a surface mount one down there, another diode, couple of resistors, and the pot, and a switch on the pot.
3 volt to 35 volt, 5 amp mini motor, PWM speed controller, LED speed control switch dimmer from SenseSmart. I won this at auction for $1.98. 90 watts maximum. Its PWM frequency is 10K, so you're not going to get humming and buzzing and flickering and stuff. Not visibly, anyways. PWM between 1% and 100%. Okay, not too much to say there. And we spent some time last week on this same circuit, so I don't have to go too deep into it today.
All right, what else did I get from that same seller here? Another module in a bag with a knob. And a 555, and a heat sink, and power plus minus, motor plus minus, and more bigger capacitors this time on the output side. So this is obviously another PWM speed controller slash dimmer unit. I guess I just got the two of them just to compare the two of them and see how they work and take a look at the two different circuits. Okay. Let's find that one on eBay.
6 volt, 12 volt, 24 volt, 28 volt, 3 amp. Wow. PWM DC motor speed control switch controller black NE555. Yeah, again from SenseSmart. Currently going for $2.25, but I got it at auction for $1.98. So, yeah, that's probably why I bought two very similar ones. I probably bid on both of them, assuming that I wouldn't get both of them, but then I did. So it goes. This isn't the link to the auction. This is them just selling it regularly. So that's the current price is $2.25 Canadian or $1.69 American. Lots to see down here. Allows controlling of the direction. I don't think it's directional. I think it's just speed. Of a DC motor using PWM with a duty cycle fully adjustable from 0 to 100%.
Can provide a continuous current of 3 amps. Input supply voltage 6 volts to 28 volts. I'm guessing they're probably doing some power supply regulation for the 555, because they don't think they can go quite that high. Maximum output power 80 watts, aka 3 amps. Connect your load to the load, connect your input to the input, adjust the knob, and there you go. Yeah, cool. I'll have to come back and compare these two circuits against the other one at some point in the future.
Okay, what is the third thing from the same seller? So this is capable of opening plastic bags. Chips. What are you guys? 555s again. Didn't I just get a package of 10 of those in my last mailbag too? Must have forgot that I ordered these ones and bought those ones or something. I don't know. Oh well, at least they're a useful chip. Fun to play with. I don't know.
10 pieces NE555P, NE555 DIP 8 single bipolar precision timers from SenseSmart again. Paid $1.32 for the 10 of them, so 13 cents each. Pretty reasonable. You can do all kinds of fun things with them. Anybody who's played with electronics is probably aware of this guy.
Well, that wasn't the most exciting mailbag in the world, but there were some interesting things in there. I mean, these will come in handy. These two modules, along with the one that I built from the kit last week, will probably show up again in another video, just as I compare the different versions of the circuit. Anyway, let's quickly go through the shipping times. The inductor assortment was 33 days. This thing, this outdoor survival tool, or so they call it, was 1 month. The mini pliers were a month minus 1 day. The surface mount resistors were, 3.5 weeks? And this assortment of things, the 555 and the two PWM boards, were again exactly 1 month. So shipping from China seems to be settling down to a fairly stable 1 month, which is better than it was this time last year, I guess. Well, thanks for stopping by on this long weekend for the bonus mailbag episode. Another video on Friday, and regularly scheduled mailbag next Monday, unless something happens and I can't get around to it. But anyways, thanks for watching. Questions, comments down below. Yeah, I know these aren't the best ones. I've heard it before. That's okay. They're cheap and they're durable, and I can blow them up, and I don't care, and they're fun to play with. Okay, I think I answered that comment that I always get every time I show 555s. Yeah, anyway, comments, questions. Thanks, as always, to my Patreon supporters for helping me finance this silliness. I appreciate it. Talk to you later.